Okay, okay.
Ooh!
Oh, big fang. Mm. Oh, that was pretty bloody X-rated. Australia's funnel web spiders have a really bad reputation all around the world. The most dangerous, the most deadly. But is that reputation warranted? Well, I'm Anne Jones from ABC Slants, and today we are watching viral videos of funnel web spiders.
The fear is really getting to me.
While you're here, if you like this sort of video, hit subscribe for more ABC Science. Rightio, come at me, spideys. I mean, only on the internet.
Open this one up.
Oh, wow. Oh, hello, booty. Hey.
Not only are they one of the world's most venomous spiders, they've got to have one of the best threat displays I've ever seen.
Ooh! Aggressive stance.
Ah.
Wait, whoa! See how fast it goes. This is her doing her best to look big and dangerous to a threat, which is this man. So she's got her legs up, she's got her fangs out, ready to strike. She's standing as big as possible.
You see the drips of venom forming on the fangs there?
They are known as aggressive spiders, but they're really not. They're defensive spiders. They're generally only doing this when you're playing with them or aggravating them in some way. So leave them alone and they probably won't attack you. Unless you're a millipede. More spideys.
These guys are highly, highly venomous. These are the Sydney funnel webs.
There's like 40 different types of funnel web spiders in Australia. And that's just the species we know. This spider, if it did strike you, could kill you.
I'm going to attempt to handle her today.
Oh no, why?
The adrenaline in me is kicking. I can feel my nerves just going.
Why? 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 No, don't do that.
This is something I've wanted to do for a long time.
You hear me, Australia? Don't do that. Just throw me these people.
So far, she's been a good girl.
You can actually die really quickly if you've got a deep envenomation from a funnel web. Basically, your heart and lungs stop working. Just because you see it on the internet doesn't mean you should do it. Do not handle wild spiders. It's really hard to tell which ones are extremely dangerous and which ones aren't. All of that being said, we haven't had a funnel web death in yonks. It's been since the 80s in Australia, and that's because we've got anti-venom, because funnel webs are incredibly lethal if you happen to get bitten. Next video. Ah. I'm here filming for ABC Catalyst, and I'm just about to go and find a bloke who, quite ridiculously, digs up funnel web spiders for his job. Let's go get him. They let me out of the studio occasionally. Oh God, I'm gonna walk into a spider web probably. And there were funnel web spiders everywhere. I was on Gari, which is Fraser Island, with some scientists, and they were digging up funnel webs, and it was insane. So, Glenn, why would you do that?
Because they're beautiful, number one, and their venoms are the most complex chemical arsenals in the entire natural world. Up to 3,000 molecules in the venom of a single spider. What's remarkable, though, is that only one of those molecules is responsible for the human envenomation syndrome, the thing that kills us.
We're not their target, though. We're just sort of collateral damage, aren't we?
We are collateral damage.
So their venom is extremely complex. There's like 3,000 molecules in it, and it just so happens that there's one in there that can really affect us, mammals. They're generally preying on insects, amphibians, things like that. They're not really after us. It's just sort of like this crazy evolutionary bingo that happened when it comes to funnel webs and us humans.
Yeah. Oh, it's actually not that big.
What? Hello.
Here we go. Oh.
Next video.
My son left his shoes out over the weekend, and this is why you should always check them before putting them back on.
Oh. tunnel webs in particular make a really cool little web array on the outside of their burrow. It's an early warning system, which you can see around the shoe tongue. Oh, now he's going to poke it. That's good. Yeah, make it angry. Yeah. Oh! And he thought he found a really good spot. When an insect or a vibration of some sort hits the end of the web, it goes up the webs that they've got on the outside of their burrow and all the way down into the sock so that they can tell who's around. You know when you go into the milk bar and it goes bing, bing when you go through the door? It's sort of like that. Next video.
Hey guys, just come down to the pool.
Nah, he's surfing.
Need a film?
Oh, I wouldn't touch him like that. Oh, why would you touch it with your hand?
So that, although it seems to be dead, is a funnel web male.
He won't necessarily be dead, mate. Ah! He's alive. So if you come across a funnel web and you need to move it or capture it for some reason, make sure you get a jar that is glass or a container that is plastic to get them in. Don't try and catch them on a stick or a piece of paper because they can grip onto those things. They can't grip onto smooth plastic or smooth glass. Still, the best thing to do if you come across any wild animal is to give it a wide berth. Let it do its thing. It's integral part of the ecosystem out there. All right. Is that an egg sac? Looks like it's made out of paper, doesn't it? Wow! The idea of having so many babies is basically as an assurance that some of them will survive. If you have like 300 of them, one of them is likely to survive. Two spiders in a container, and that can only mean one thing: love.
The entire mating takes about 5 minutes. You know, he's slowly just trying to get to her underside.
The female's the larger one. Male looks nervous, and he should. Many males don't make it out of a mating encounter alive.
You can see Harry there. He's just tapping. Minerva's a bit hesitant, so she's striking out a little bit just so he keeps his distance.
She was reading a good book, you know? She doesn't want to be irritated by a bloke. But then he starts his little drum beat.
Seems Minerva's finally accepting Harry.
What's really crazy is that the females will stick with their one burrow for their entire life. They'll only come out to hunt. The males, however, they will. They will get out and go in search of females so that they can mate, just like what we saw there. But it does mean that there are males wandering around with two fistfuls of ejaculate. And if you think it was the Kardashians that made the nice round booty all popular, no, it's not. It's bloody funnel webs. Look at it. Nice booty. Thanks for watching, and if you've got a suggestion for an animal for How Deadly, leave it in a comment below. Catch you next time.